sorry, excuse me.
Be careful, sweetie.
Did Brady and Madeline tell you who their characters are in the play tonight?
No, they said they wanted it to be a surprise.
Mrs. Miller is so good at doing costumes, though. I don't even know that we'll recognize our own children. No, I doubt that, Anita.
Quick, Earl, get the camera. Welcome, everyone, to my third grade class's production of the traditional Christmas Nativity Story. It's so nice to see so many familiar faces out in the audience. Our students have worked extremely hard on this play. So, without any further ado, the Nativity Story.
About 2,000 years ago, in a town called Nazareth, lived a young woman named Mary. She was engaged to marry a man named Joseph, a carpenter.
Oh, Mary, you make me feel like the luckiest carpenter in all of Nazareth. I'll see you tomorrow.
One day, the angel Gabriel appeared to Mary.
Oh my goodness! Where did you come from?
I have come from heaven to deliver a message from God. Peace be with you. God has blessed you and is pleased with you.
Well, I wasn't expecting that. I mean, he's glad to hear he's pleased with me, but what is this all about?
Don't be afraid. God has been very kind to you. You will become pregnant by the Holy Spirit and give birth to a baby boy. And you will call him Jesus. He will be God's own son, and his kingdom will never end.
Pregnant? Already? Well, let it happen as God chooses.
Joseph was a bit confused when Mary told him she was already pregnant.
Mary, is there someone else? Please, tell me!
No, Joseph, it's nothing like that. I'm carrying the Son of God.
Joseph wasn't sure if the wedding should be put off. But that night, an angel appeared to him in a dream. Don't be afraid, Joseph. Mary has been chosen by God to be the mother of his son, and the baby will be named Jesus, which means Savior, and he will be the Savior of his people.
All right, I must not be afraid. Mary will still be my wife.
During this time, the land where Mary and Joseph lived was part of the Roman Empire. The Roman Emperor Augustus wanted to have a list of all the people in the empire to make sure they were paying their taxes. He ordered everyone to return to the town where their family came from and be counted by the census there.
Do we have to go, Joseph? My baby will be born so soon.
We have to go, but we will travel slowly and carefully.
Mary and Joseph traveled a long way from Nazareth to Bethlehem because that is where Joseph's family came from. When they arrived, they had difficulty finding somewhere to stay.
Joseph, where will we sleep?
I don't know. All of the houses are full.
Every bed is taken.
Well, why don't you ask the keeper of this inn? Excuse me, do you have anywhere that we might be able to sleep tonight? My wife is very pregnant. I'm afraid the only place I have is the room with the animals. But if you like, you may sleep there.
Thank you.
That night, in the manger where the animals slept, Mary gave birth to Jesus.
He's beautiful, Mary.
In the hills and fields outside of Bethlehem, a shepherd, who coincidentally looked just like the innkeeper, looked after his sheep. Suddenly, an angel appeared and said, "Don't be afraid, because I have good news for you. Today in Bethlehem, a savior has been born for you. You will find the baby lying in a manger."
I think I'll go to Bethlehem and see.
The shepherd went to Bethlehem and found Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus lying in the manger just as he had been told. He told everyone he knew what the angel had said. When Jesus was born, a brand new bright star appeared in the sky. Three wise men from faraway lands saw the star and guessed what it meant. They were scholars and they knew that a new star would appear when a great king was born. They set out to find him and bring him gifts.
What do you bring for a baby king who you haven't met before? Maybe a gift certificate? iTunes? Animal Jam?
The wise men followed the star towards the country of Judea. When they got to the capital called Jerusalem, they began to ask people where the baby king was.
He's got to be here somewhere.
King Herod heard this and he became very angry.
So someone wants to take my place as king? Nonsense. I must talk to them. Oh, hi. I hear you're following that star in the sky to find the baby king. Well, I also want to worship that baby. As soon as you find him, just let me know where he is so that I can go and worship him too. Not a problem, King Herod.
King Herod did not tell the wise men about his evil plan.
I don't think those wise men are so wise after all. I'm not going to worship the new king. I'm going to kill him. Just as soon as these men lead me right to him.
The wise men followed the star towards Bethlehem, where it said that the king would be born in the old writings. It seemed to stop and shine directly down onto the place where Jesus was born. The wise men entered and found Jesus with Mary. They bowed down and worshipped him.
Oh, wow! All this for Jesus?
The wise men spread the gifts they had brought before Jesus.
We have gold, frankincense, and myrrh. I hope he likes them. How did you know? That's just what I needed for the baby.
That night, the wise men had a dream. They were warned by God not to go back to Herod, so they returned home on a different path. That night, an angel also appeared to Joseph in a dream.
Get up, the angel said. Take Jesus and Mary and escape to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you, for Herod is going to search for Jesus to kill him.
Joseph got up and took Jesus and Mary during the night to Egypt. When King Herod realized that he had been tricked by the wise men, he was furious.
I will not be tricked! Kill all the boys aged 2 or younger in Bethlehem and the surrounding area. This new king will not survive.
But Jesus, Joseph, and Mary had already escaped to Egypt. They stayed there until one night, Joseph had another dream in which an angel appeared to him. Get up, said the angel, and go back to Israel, for those who were trying to kill Jesus are dead. So Joseph got up and took Jesus and Mary back to Israel. When they heard that Herod's son was now king of Judea, he was afraid to go there. So instead they went to Galilee and lived in their old town of Nazareth.
Anita?
Yes, Errol?
Were our children really in that play?
I have no idea.